बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड योर रमज़ान इज़ गोइंग वेल एंड यू आर डूइंग योर स्टडीज़। स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस फ्यू टॉपिक्स ऑफ यूनिट 9, फर्स्ट स्टेप टू द इंटरनेट। द टॉपिक्स वर इंटरनेट रिक्वायरमेंट्स फॉर कनेक्टिंग टू द इंटरनेट वर्ल्ड वाइड वेब WWW सर्च इंजन्स। नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ईमेल, netiquette, safety on the internet. Friends, before starting today's lecture, I want to show you a video for recap. This video is recorded from Oxford Word website.
Hi Goggle, why such a long face? Oh, Toggle, you will not be able to help me this time. Tell me what's the matter? Tomorrow is Rusum's birthday. You know, he is one of my closest friends. So I wanted to gift him the book Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone on his birthday. So what is the problem? I have searched and searched, but it is not available at any of the bookstores in our neighborhood. Is that all? Don't worry, I can make many other bookstores appear as if by magic. It is quite likely the book you are looking for is available in one of them.
How can you do that, Toggle?
We can use the internet to search for more bookstores in the neighborhood and we may find a few shops we were not aware of.
Okay, can we use the internet to search for a bookstore as well?
Sure, Goggle. Not only can you search for a bookstore, but you can also buy a book over the internet through online bookstores.
Really, Toggle? I know that both Mom and Dad use the internet at home as well as in office. Toggle, why is it called the internet?
Internet stands for Interconnected Network. It is a huge connection of millions of computers around the world which are capable of sharing information with each other. The internet is used for many different purposes nowadays. The internet can also be called a huge storehouse of information.
You just said that the internet is used for many different purposes nowadays. Can you tell me about a few of them?
Sure, Goggle. Well, to start with, we can search for information on the internet on any topic we want and take out exactly what we need. Through the internet, we can send messages to any part of the world within a few seconds. And then we can chat with friends on the internet.
Wow, that's really wonderful, Toggle.
That's not all, Goggle. We can buy things over the internet and have them delivered to our homes.
So I can buy a book through the internet and it will be delivered to my address.
Yes, Goggle. This is known as e-commerce and popularly called online shopping.
The internet is such a wonderful facility, Toggle. Tell me, how do we really get connected to the internet?
There are two types of internet connections, dial-up and broadband.
No idea what these are.
Dial-up technology and some wired broadband connections use a phone line to connect to the internet.
So is that all we need, Toggle?
No, we necessarily need to have a modem and an internet service provider or ISP also for it.
What is a modem, Toggle?
A modem is a device that allows a computer to connect and communicate with other computers. Modem stands for modulator, demodulator. There are three types of modem connections. They are cable modem, telephone modem, and wireless modem.
How are they different?
A cable modem is a device that helps you connect your computer to a local cable TV line and then allows you to access the internet.
And a telephone modem?
A telephone modem is a device that helps you connect your computer to a telephone line to access internet services.
Got it. And what is a wireless modem?
A wireless modem transmits data signals through the air instead of a cable. It is specially designed to work with cell phone networks and wireless local area networks.
Where is the modem fitted in a computer, Toggle? A modem can be an internal modem or an external modem. An internal modem is fitted inside a computer, whereas an external modem is placed outside the computer. Coming back to dial-up connections, it is a very slow method of accessing the internet, and it is hardly used in cities nowadays. So, how do we get a faster internet connection? By using a broadband connection. How does it help, Toggle? Broadband technology enables high-speed internet access through an existing phone line. Actually, a broadband connection can be of three types: wired broadband, wireless broadband, or wireless mobile broadband. Okay, but what does broadband really mean? A broadband is like a highway with many lanes. Data can use any lane to travel. This is why broadband is able to provide high speeds it has become known for. Okay, now what is a wired broadband? Wired broadband is a high-speed internet service that you can use through wired technology. How does this wired technology work? In this technology, a broadband modem is connected to a phone line through which it receives the internet service. And what is wireless broadband? Wireless broadband service gives you an internet connection without any wires. How can we access the internet without any wires, Toggle? Well, Goggle, in this technology, a wireless broadband modem receives the signals from a phone line or through satellite and then transmits it to a few feet of its surroundings. You know, I have seen people accessing the internet on their laptops while they are traveling. How is that possible? That is possible due to wireless mobile broadband technology. You need a special device called a dongle for that. What is a dongle, Toggle? Well, a dongle looks very similar to a pen drive. You just plug it in your laptop or desktop and follow the instructions to connect to the internet. I have seen so many people using it. It must be very easy to connect to the internet with a dongle. Yes, Goggle, it is a very flexible medium to get access to the internet and so is very popular amongst internet users. Okay, Toggle, now that I know what the internet is, how do I go about getting an internet connection? To get an internet connection, you need a subscription with any internet service provider for which you have to pay a monthly charge. Who provides this service in our city, Toggle? There are many, such as
a PGCL, Nayatel, Vitribe.
Look, Goggle, I have a dongle. Why don't we connect it to your computer and access the internet? Yes, Toggle, let's do that. First, search the internet for a nearby store that sells the book I need. Hi, Toggle. I love working on the computer. I know that, Goggle. Toggle, you have told me so much about the internet, but I still don't know how to really use the internet. Can you help me? Hi, Toggle. I love working on the computer. I know that, Goggle. Toggle, you have told me so much about the internet, but I still don't know how to really use the internet. Can you help me? Sure, Goggle. But before that, you will need to know certain facts about the World Wide Web. World Wide Web? What kind of web is that now? The World Wide Web, or simply the web, is the part of the internet that we actually access. It forms only one part of the internet and the only part which can be accessed by any person anywhere in the world. It is called a web because it is a system of billions of interlinked pages that contain a variety of information. To access the World Wide Web, you need a web browser. What is a web browser, Toggle? A web browser is a program used to locate and display web pages. It also helps you interact with text, images, videos, music, and other information located on web pages. Can you give me some examples? Internet Explorer,
Mozilla Firefox and Google Chrome are good examples. Toggle, what's the difference between web pages and websites? The individual pages that collectively form the World Wide Web are known as web pages. They may contain text, images, videos, or music. Okay, sometimes a web page may have words that are underlined and colored, or a small image called an icon. When you place your mouse pointer over those words or images, the pointer would change to a hand symbol. What does that mean, Toggle? It means that clicking on this text or image will take the user to another page of related information. Oh, that's cool! Yes, such links of one web page with another are called hyperlinks. So, what's a website? A website is a collection of one or more related web pages linked together through a system of hyperlinks. For example, www.discoveryeducation.com is a website. A website is similar to a magazine. You can move from one page to another on a website using the hyperlinks in the same way that you flip through the pages of a magazine. Okay, now I get it. Now, Goggle, let me open the Discovery Kids website for you. Look at these words and symbols at the top of the browser carefully. This is the web address for this website. The web address? A web address is the address or location of a website on the internet. All addresses start with either HTTP or www. To visit a website, type the address of the website in the address bar and then press the Enter key. Goggle, the first page that opens when you type in a website address is called the home page. Also remember that you should type the address on a website correctly without leaving any space between the words or letters or symbols. Okay, Toggle. Toggle, but what if I do not know the address of a website and wish to search the web for information on a particular thing? It is quite simple, Goggle. Just like you look at the contents page of a book to know on which page the required chapter starts, similarly on the internet, we use a search engine. A search engine? I do not see any engine here. A search engine is a program that searches through a collection of web pages for information on a specific topic or theme. That is what we used to search for the list of bookstores in our neighborhood the other day. How does a search engine help us search for anything on the web? Search engines allow you to enter a keyword or phrase that indicates the information that you want. It then scans the internet, searches for the information, and displays a list of websites with related information. Cool! Can you give me some examples of search engines? Sure, Goggle. www.google.com and Yahoo Search are two good examples. Toggle, yesterday my mom sent a greeting card through the internet to my aunt who lives in London. Pretty soon, she sent a...
Here is the recap of the last video. Check your answers and spellings. Now students, for today's lecture, I want to show you again a video which is recorded from the Oxford website.
Toggle, yesterday my mom sent a greeting card through the internet to my aunt who lives in London. Pretty soon, she sent a thank you message to mom. It was so fast. That's the power of email. Email? Yes, I have heard about it. Can you tell me more on how it works? An email is an electronic message sent from one computer to another, which can include text, pictures, and even sound. Wow! Through the internet, this whole process takes just a few seconds, allowing you to communicate quickly and easily with millions of people around the world any time of the day or night. Gosh, that's cool! It is so much better than having to send a letter or a courier. Yes, Goggle, a letter or a courier would require both time and money, while the internet can do it for you almost free and also save a lot of time. How can I send or receive emails from my friends? For that, you as well as your friends will have to open an email account with any email service provider. Will I have to pay money to open an account with an email service provider? No, not really. Many service providers such as www.google.com, www.yahoo.com and www.outlook.com offer email accounts free of charge. They will charge money only if you want to use more space for your mailbox. All you have to do is to register, choose an email ID and create a password to avail the free service. Do I have to use only my computer every time I send or receive an email? No, Goggle. You can access your mailbox from anywhere provided you have an internet connection. I'll do one thing. I'll quickly open an email account for you, Goggle. How's that sound? Cool, Toggle. Please do. There you are, your inbox. Wow, thanks, Toggle. Tell me, whom do you want to send an email to? Can we send a message to my friend Chanila? Sure, why not? First, click on the Compose button. All right, done. Now what, Toggle? Now, to compose a message and send it to your friend, first type the email address of the person you want to send the message to. Shanila's email address is shanila@yahoo.com. Good. Now in the subject line, type a brief description of the message. Done that? Next, type in your message in the main message box and then click on send. What if I want to read the message again? By default, a copy of the sent message is stored in the sent folder. Oh great, I have sent a message to Shanila. Now I too can send emails to... Yes, Goggle. Now you know quite a bit about the internet and also know how to send emails to all your friends around the world. However, there is a set of rules known as netiquette that you should follow. Netiquette? What is that? Well, Goggle, netiquette means the etiquette needed when you're on the internet. The internet, just like the world we live in, has certain rules that people should follow. So tell me, what are these set of rules or netiquette that I should keep in mind? When using the net to send mails to others, you should always spell check what you have written to help others understand you correctly. Do not use all caps in your mails or online messages because it is considered shouting. Be truthful in the information you provide online. However, mind the rules for safety that you have been told about. Be yourself even when you're online and do not say or do things that you will not do otherwise. Okay, Toggle, I promise to always keep these rules in mind while surfing the net or while sending emails to my friends. Besides netiquette, there are also some safety measures that you should take while using the internet. Safety measures while using the internet? But why are these needed? Look, Goggle, the internet may be a wonderful place and can be a lot of fun besides being an amazing source of useful information. However, just like the world outside, it can also be a scary place at times. Keep the following safety tips in mind when you're online. Do not give out personal information on the internet like your address, telephone number, parents' work address, or name and location of your school without your parents' permission. Okay, what else? If you join a game or chat group on the internet with your parents' permission, you should never give out your password to anyone in that group. You should immediately inform your parents if you come across any information that makes you feel uncomfortable. Never send anyone your picture or your personal data on the internet without asking your parents. Do not respond to any messages that make you feel uncomfortable in any way. Always communicate with your parents so that together you can set up rules for going online. Okay, Toggle, I will definitely follow these safety rules while using the net. Great, then go ahead and explore the net, Goggle.
Students, on page number 138 of your textbook, you have an exercise. After watching the video, do this exercise by yourself. The internet was developed by Department of Defense of the USA. The first page of a website is called its home page. A highlighted word that on being clicked takes you to another web page, hyperlink. A company that allows you to connect to the internet on payment of a fee is called an ISP. When the mouse pointer is moved over a hyperlinked image or text, the pointer changes to a dash symbol, hand symbol. Fill in the blanks. Students, you have to do these fill in the blanks on your notebook. A dash is a device that allows a computer to connect and communicate with other computers. Modem. A dash is a small USB device that allows you to access the internet through a mobile broadband connection. Dongle. A dash is a collection of one or more related web pages linked together through a system of hyperlinks. Website. And dash is an electronic message sent from one computer to another, which can include text, pictures, and sounds. Email. Do not give your dash information to anyone on the internet without your parents' permission. Personal information. True/false. Again, you have to do on the notebook. The internet is a huge network of computers around the world. It's true. Safari is a search engine. Yes, it is also true. The World Wide Web is that part of the internet that no one can access. It's false because everyone can access it. A web page can contain text, graphics, audio, video, and links to other pages. Yes, it is true. You should use all caps in your mail or online messages. It's false because it calls shouting. Students, you have a worksheet number 3 on page number 141 and 142 of your textbook. Student, close the video, solve the worksheet, and then again play the video and check your answers. Be honest while doing this. Now, students, our final term syllabus has been completed. Next time, you will receive worksheets. Use those worksheets to assess yourself how much you have understood from these videos. Thank you.